Sprites are an essential graphic element in any game, regardless of its genre, and adding animations to your sprites can take the look of your game to a whole new level. But frame-by-frame animations are hard, and having multiple frame-by-frame animations can make your game bulky. For example, if I wanted to add these two very mediocre animations to my game, I'd have to create a sprite sheet for them. And this is what that sprite sheet would look like. And this is for only two animations, the idle animation and the walking animation. If you wanted to add more, it would add megabytes for the player to download, and also adds to the memory usage of your game. Now, compare this sprite sheet to the texture sheet that we use in Life 2D8 animation. This singular texture sheet would be used for every single animation, and each additional animation is just the .json text file. And once you know what you're doing, it gets easy to create new animations with your sprite without having to commission the artist to make another set of animations. Additionally, if you want to change something regarding the sprite, for example, if you want to change her hair color or the color of the shoes, you don't have to redraw every single frame of the animation. You can just recolor the texture sheet, and it would automatically update all of the animations as well. Same goes for changing the outfit. So in this series, I'd like to show you how to create game sprites and animations using Life 2D. Today we're going to start with part separation, as in, how to separate the art into different parts that we can move in Life 2D. As a side note, if you're already planning on using Life 2D animation for your game, I'd recommend that you search for an artist that already knows how to separate parts for Life 2D so you don't have to do this yourself, and you can just start animating. Now, I'm going to be separating the parts for this sprite, which is a character sprite for an upcoming visual novel. But you can use these principles to separate the parts for a platformer character or fighting game character or any other kind of sprite that you want to create. So currently you can only import .psd files into Life2D, so we're going to import any of our sprites into a software that can export as a .psd file. And I'm going to be using Clip Studio Paint, but please note that currently the only confirmed softwares that can load PSDs into Live 2D are Adobe Photoshop and Clip Studio Paint. The first thing I'm going to do is pick our default sprite, and this is going to be the one that we use as a base for all of the different parts we want set up. This is going to be my default sprite. Before we separate anything, we're going to think about the parts that we actually want to move. For me, that's usually the hair, eyes, mouth, torso, and the limbs. Now you can either start from the frontmost layer or the furthest layer on the back, but I usually start from the back and work my way to the front. And this is what it's going to look like once it's all finished. Starting with the back layers, I'm going to separate any background elements that might be part of the character, like cape or long hair. These elements are usually very, very far behind the character's body and layered beneath everything else, so it's pretty easy to separate them. Then we move on to the torso and the limbs. So I definitely want the upper body and the arms to move, but I don't really think I'm going to do much with her legs, so I'm not going to separate that further. For the arms, however, I'm going to separate it into the left and right arm so that I can animate them independently. Next, we're going to separate the base head layer. Basically, just the color of the head without the cheeks, the eyes, the mouth, or anything like that. Next, we're going to separate the eyes. So, I'm going to show you two methods of separating the eyes just for this tutorial. The first method is a simple method just to get you used to the Live 2D workspace and how to actually move things. It's just going to be the open eyes and the closed eyes and the eyebrows. And then here we have the standard method, which is the sclera, the iris, upper lower lashes, and the eyebrows. Both of these separated into left eye and right eye versions. Now that we're done with that, we're going to move on with the mouth. Similarly to the eyes, I'm going to show you two methods for the mouth. For the simple method, we just have separate mouth layers for the different mouth shapes. And for the standard method, we're going to separate it into the base mouth, the inner parts of the mouth, which is top and bottom teeth and the tongue, and then the top and bottom lip. And then we're going to separate the nose and then for the front hair we're just going to separate any piece that we want to move independently. You can separate this further into her bangs and the sides of the hair, but just for this tutorial I'll just separate the entire front piece as one big piece. Once all the parts are separated into their own layers, make sure that each layer is clearly labeled, including specifying right or left layers whenever necessary, just to make it easier to identify when we're working on it in Live 2D. And then we're going to export this file as a .psd file and import it into Live 2D. And you can just drag and drop it in. And this is going to be the foundation for your entire model and any animation that you want to make, so make sure to save it. And in the next part of the series, we're going to cover the basics of setting up the model in Live 2D. Thank you for watching!
この番組はご覧のメンバーの提供でお送りします。